Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to show you three ways you can control what is and isn't included in your Google Analytics 4 reports. We're going to look at filtering options for GA4. Let's get started. I've already logged into Google's demo account, so let's start by navigating to Reports. Then Engagement. And then Pages and Screens. This report shows us all of the pages people have viewed on our website. By default, it will include all the pages on our website, but let's say you wanted to exclude a section of pages from appearing in this report. To do this, we can apply a filter. At the top of the report, there is an option that lets us add a filter. Let's select this. On the right, we can now set the filter conditions that we want to apply to the report. Let's select Include and change this to Exclude. Now we click Select Dimension. And let's search for and select Page Path and Screen Class. Now we need to enter a value for the dimension. In this example, we will be excluding whatever we enter here from our report. When we click Select Dimension Values, you will see a list of the top pages you can exclude. So if you like, you can select pages individually using this list. However, we can also begin typing to exclude everything that contains the value we enter. So I'm going to enter /Google+redesign/. This will mean that we'll be excluding all of the pages in this folder from the report. Now we need to select the All Values Containing option at the top. This means we'll be excluding all the pages that contain /Google+redesign/. Now we click Apply on the bottom right corner. The report updates. And now we're excluding that section of the website from our report. Applying filters like this to your reports is a great way to focus what is presented in Google Analytics. However, the drawback of using this technique is that as soon as you navigate away from the report, the filter will be removed and you'll need to create the filter again. To see this, let's navigate to the Landing Pages report. And then back to the Pages and Screens report. Looking at the top, the filter is no longer being applied to the report, so this is very temporary. If you have editor or administrator level permission for the Google Analytics property, then you can save the filter so that it's automatically applied to the report when people use it. Let's head to my demo property to see this. We're looking at a similar report to the one we saw in Google's demo account. And since I have editor level permission for this property, we can see there is a pencil icon on the top right corner to customize the report. Let's select this. On the right, we can see there's an option to add a filter to the report. Let's select Add Filter. We can now add a filter like we did previously. So this time, let's add a filter that only includes a particular section of the website. Let's leave Include selected, and let's click Select Dimension. Now let's search for and select Hostname. Hostname is the top-level domain for your website, so if you have Google Analytics installed on multiple domains, then you can use this to only view an individual website in your reports. Now I'm going to select the domains for the websites I want to include in my report. When you're happy, click OK, and then Apply. Now we need to save the changes to our report, so let's click Save. And I'm going to select the option to save the changes to the current report. Now we can navigate back. At the top of the report, we can now see that the filter is applied, and because we saved it to the report, it means that it will be applied by default whenever someone views the report again. Let's test this by navigating to Events. and then back to Pages and Screens. We can see the filter continues to be applied by default. And the nice thing about using this method is that the filter will be applied for anybody else who has access to the report. Plus, they can always remove the filter to see the full set of data available for the report. Apart from applying filters to the default reports, you can also apply filters to custom exploration reports you create in Google Analytics. Let's take a look at this by heading back to Google's demo property. And let's navigate to Explore. And let's create a new exploration report. At the bottom, there is an option to apply a filter to the exploration report. Once we've added dimensions and metrics to our report, we'll be able to use this option. Let's keep things simple and create another filtered report based on the pages on our website. To do this, let's add a dimension to the report. This time, I'm going to add the landing page dimension. And then I'm going to add some metrics. Let's add views and engagement rate. Now let's add the dimension and metrics to the report. Now let's select filters in the second column. We can choose to filter the report based on the dimensions or metrics we've added. For this report, let's create a filter that only includes pages with a significant number of page views. So let's choose views. Now we can choose the condition. I'm going to select greater than, and then I'm going to enter 4,000. This will mean that the report only includes landing pages that have at least 4,000 page views. Now let's click Apply. We can see the report updates, and we've now filtered the results included in the table. So there are three techniques you can use to quickly filter what's included and excluded from your reports in Google Analytics. Apart from these techniques, if you find that you need to filter reports on a regular basis, then you can also apply filters to reports you create in Looker Studio, and you can filter information before it's processed into your reports using Google Tag Manager to adjust your implementation. If you'd like to see me cover more of these techniques in a future video, please let me know in the comments below. And to learn more about Google Analytics, check out my courses. I've included links in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.